She won team gold on Wednesday after 18 months away from the gym. And now Simone Biles is aiming to top the podium again. She's been outstanding in her comeback so far. But can she claim her sixth world all-around title? Looking forward to seeing Simone Biles back again this evening, but we've had some bad news for British gymnastics fans. In the last half an hour, Jessica Gadarova, who took bronze in the all-round last year, has been forced to pull out. So let's just hope that everything is all right. Now, three times world champion Beth Tweddle is in the studio with me to talk through all of the action. So let's just start, Beth, with that news. We understand she had a bit of an injury in warm-up.
Yeah, so we know that she had come into the arena. She'd done most of the warm-up. By the sounds of it, she's injured herself on the vault, which is obviously the last piece prior to going out and performing on it. As a precautionary measure, they've pulled her out. That will allow doctors, medics to assess her. She has still got three apparatus finals, so there is the possibility if she's OK, she can still perform in them.
Yeah. One of them being vault, and that's at the, on Saturday. So, obviously, time will tell. But Jess stepping out means that the replacement, good news for British gymnastics fans, is that Alice Kinsella is in.
Yeah, with the three-country rule, two-per-country rule, Alice, although she had qualified to the top 24, was not able to perform. So she won't have had much chance to warm up. She will have been ready to go, but obviously won't have warmed up on all the apparatus. But Alice is a very experienced gymnast. She knows her routines.
She came fourth, didn't she, at last year's Worlds?
She did. And sometimes, actually, not having all that build-up, it takes the pressure away. And she literally went up first. So, straight in.
Yeah. We wish her all the very best. Absolutely. Now, obviously, Biles is going to be the favourite. She was the highest qualifier. But it's not going to be easy for her because there's some tough competition in this. Rebecca Andrade of Brazil and also Shailese Jones, her teammate from the US.
Yeah, there is. It's going to be an interesting competition. We know that Simone has got the kind of difficulty in the execution, but Shailese Jones will be pushing her all the way, as will Rebecca. And she's fresh off medal success two nights ago. So, I think tonight is going to be who stays on.
Well, obviously disappointment for Jess, but all eyes will be on Simone Biles. It's brilliant to have her back, but it hasn't been an easy journey.
Simone Biles is the greatest gymnast of our generation, but her journey to glory hasn't always been an easy one.
Well, Simone was born in Columbus, Ohio, to my daughter from my first marriage. My daughter had problems. She was involved with drugs and alcohol. When the kids were placed in the foster care, I asked the social workers to send them to us here in Texas.
Simone was just full of life, always jumping, always talking.
Hyper, loud, and energetic.
One day at the daycare, they were going on a field trip. It was raining. So my son said, well, let's go over to this gymnastics facility that wasn't too far.
She had never been to one before. Whatever she was doing caught the eyes of the coaches.
I just remember seeing the girls in the back gym, which were the teen kids, and they were flipping around. And I was like, oh, I think I could do that. So I started copying them.
By the time she was nine, she was one of the best gymnasts in Texas.
From the best in Texas at nine to the world stage at 16. Quite a leap for the young woman from Houston, but defying gravity is what she does best.
A worthy world champion.
And from there, it was crazy.
The whole world knew who she was.
Yes.
And at her first Olympic Games in Rio, her name was to be written into the history books.
Simone Biles gets her fourth gold medal at the Rio Olympics.
But behind this tale of incredible success lay a dark truth, a story of bravery and courage, of daring to speak out against abuse.
Speaking up about it and knowing that I helped so many other survivors out there, I think honestly, that's what helped me and to know that I wasn't going through it alone.
Her story is of bravery, even this summer, when the whole world was watching and expecting.
That wasn't what we're accustomed to seeing.
She called me. She was devastated and crying and saying that she cannot do it. And so I just told her, I said, then don't do it.
I'm sorry. No, I love you guys.
Simone put her Olympic journey on hold. She put her mental health first.
I wouldn't change it for the world. I think it did a lot of good, and it showed people that we are human, not just athletes and entertainment. And I'll rise up,
I'll rise like the day. Courageous and not defeated, she stepped up one more time in the Tokyo arena.
To the delight of the gymnastics world, Simone Biles is back.
She was able to do it. And I think, I think it did amaze the entire world.
This, her seventh Olympic medal, to add to her 25 World Championship medals. Exceptional. Inspirational. Simply one of a kind.
So emotional to watch that back, isn't it? And to have, you know, talked through those routines and to have witnessed that, what she went through there. Obviously, she's been through an enormous amount in her short life, but the twisties that came in at the last Olympics, you know, she's really battled through that. So how do you think she's worked through that, Beth, to get back onto the international gymnastics stage now?
Yeah, that would have been so difficult because even as an athlete, when you're going through that, it's tough enough as it is, let alone to be facing that problem when you're basically in the eyes of the whole world. Literally everyone was watching. How would she come back for a competition? Would she be able to do the all-around? Would she be able to? There was constant questions, and to see her come out and do that beam final and walk away with a medal was really special. Obviously, after that, she will have taken time. She will have worked with her personal coaches, with the team around her. Some gymnasts just choose never to do that certain skill again. For some gymnasts, it is only one skill that affects them. Some, it can be a range of skills. So
it's a fear of twisting, basically.
You go into the air, you have no idea where you are, and obviously that can be very dangerous in gymnastics. And for her, it was literally any twist, because she put out posts during the Olympics of her trying to twist off bars and just getting completely lost. So that's why she came back for beam, because everything was kind of just rotating rather than twisting. So she spent time obviously away from the sport, and will have, when she's returned, taken it day by day, step by step with a coach to work out what skills work for her.
Well, she is looking like the most incredible class act, what she's come through. I mean, she's married now. She's got a very different perspective on the sport, and she's here for all the right reasons. And she looks like she's loving it, doesn't she?
She does, and that is kind of going across all the gymnasts. If you see your role model, an idol, an icon of the sport, enjoying it, then you think, do you know what? Why can't we kind of follow in that?
Well, it was vault that was first up for the top gymnasts. Four apparatus to get through before we find out the all-around champion. So let's catch up with all of the action with your commentators Christine Still and Craig Heap.
So on to the vault, Alice Kinsella for Great Britain.
She's competing a double twist here. She needs to focus, flip on strongly, two twists. Good landing, nicely down the middle.
Good start for Alice.
Well, she's had very little warning.
Really does understand this vault. Back flips on, wraps into the double twist. Just that step back won't be too costly.
I think she and her coach, Brett Ince, will be very pleased.
13.766. Great start for Alice.
Shalice Jones for the USA opens her competition.
Big vault, five on the difficulty, hugely powerful. Wraps in there. Well, look at the height and the flight on that double twist. Bags of time. Silver medalist last year. Will be doing all she can to go one better. Beautiful work, Christine.
Yes, and she is a beautiful gymnast.
14.233. Shalice Jones. Great score. 9.233 on execution. Up into second. And just watch the way she attacks the vault. Huge! The round off, half turn, handspring, straight front, one and a half twist. Absolutely sky high. 5.6, the difficulty. That's out of 15.6. Christine, that's got to get close to the 15s.
I was just amazed how long that was. I thought for 1 minute she was going to miss her hands on the end of the vault, but in slow motion it looks quite secure. But it really is, she travels the whole length of the platform, and of course the springy bit is at the end. Now this is a gymnast to watch. Kalia Namur. I've seen her compete for France as a junior. She's working for Algeria here, and this is her piece.
Yep. I've seen quite a bit of this on social media. One of the best bar routines you will see. Stooping to the straight catch, down to the low bar, immediately down and back up. Stalled a full turn. Stalled a catch with a half turn. Down to the low bar, back to the top bar. Stoop full turn, she goes straight into the dismount, double layout. What a routine! Fabulous, fabulous bar work.
She's qualified, I think, second on bars, yep, in the for the final, so it'll really be a treat to see her there. And of course, she's one of the gymnasts without a team, so she hasn't competed. Oh my goodness, look at that score, 15.2. Rebecca Andrade, world champion last year, phenomenal vaulter.
Watch this. This is probably the best performed vault. Look at that! The round off, half turn, handspring, into the straight front somersault, the one and a half twist. Without doubt, the highest vault in this championships. Just blocks right in the time, the delay before the one and a half twist. I mean, that's perfection, Christine. Now, first look at Ondine Achampon onto the beam. I'm going to let Christine talk you through this routine.
And Ondine did a tremendous beam in the team final. Super start, jump into a split handstand. Free walkover, she joins really well into the two jumps. The split and then the straddle. Has to focus now for this big acrobatic series. A backflip, a layout, a second layout. All well done, Ondine. Just the tiniest of readjustments. Free cartwheel, lovely landing. Here comes the big leap, the change leg to ring. Into the split jump ring. She's got super technique on the beam. And she's such a graceful gymnast as well. Super spin. Sideways dance. Everybody has to include a little bit of that in their routine these days. And here comes the big dismount. This, you need to be so precise. One flip, two flips, punch the beam, two and a half twist, little step to the side, but as her first piece in her first all-around World Championship final, that was very solid.
Yeah, exactly. First piece of apparatus, the beam, 13.6 for Ondine. I just think if you get through the beam, Christine, you've got a fighting chance.
Come on. Yeah, there we go.
How about that? After round one, Kalia Namur from Algeria tops the pile ahead of Simone Biles. Then Rebecca Andrade, 10th for Alice Kinsella, 11th for Ondine Achapong.
Very good, very good.
So, Kalia Namur in the lead, Beth. Didn't really come as too much of a surprise. Such a fantastic bar worker.
Oh, I mean, the videos of her routine have been going around social media for the past few months and absolutely superb. She's going to be one contending for that final.
So we've had the update on where we're at after the first rotation. Simone Biles currently in second place, but here she is on bars with the first of the second rotation.
Simone Biles onto the bars.
Well, she starts with the unusual combination up into the shab. Now she's a little untidy on the legs there, but cleanly into the full pirouette. Here comes the big tight catch-air down to the low bar. Such energy, huge flight. Up to the high bar again. Full pirouette into the full twisting double back. Really packed together well, this routine.
She's so explosive. Look at that. A little look to go, whoo! But she looks so confident. Whatever piece of apparatus she's on, it's just that confidence she uses of, I'm going to get through this routine. The question is, with what quality? And look at the height there. Drifts above the bar. Plenty of time to spot the bar in the catch-ev. You control the swing down. Pitch the feet up. Back somersault, the back somersault down to the low bar. The thing I love about her gymnastics, Christine, is she makes it look effortless.
Yeah, and she has such energy, like that she's swinging as well at the end as she is at the beginning.
13.966 for Mourinho of Mexico.
Philippa Martins of Portugal, the third vaulter up in this group.
4.2 on the difficulty. Opt in for the Yushchenko with the full twist. Again, probably not one of the most difficult vaults, but performs it so well.
Well, she was seventh in the all-round a couple of years ago at the World Championships.
Not too far away from Porto in the north of Portugal.
And that was a well-executed full twist. Not so difficult. The more twists you add, the more score you get.
Simone Biles currently in the lead, 14.333. She's halfway around. Beam next. Flavia Sereva of Brazil. She's next up on bars. Qualified in sixth.
Lovely handstand, full pirouette. Big catch if it looks a bit long. And although she got cleanly over the bar, she just didn't have the height to be able to see the bar cleanly. Of course, the gymnasts from Brazil absolutely thrilled with their team performance, have to get themselves back in the groove for tonight. That was nice, the Pak Salto. Here's the Shap, swinging high. Ooh, pulled the Ginga Saltoing fairly close. Nice forward element, forward giant. Into the double front, she landed well. But the damage was done, a mark off in the middle.
What a shame. Two Brazilian gymnasts who took the historic team medal are in this top group.
Interesting, two of the girls that were in the team competition have fallen from the bars. Dos Santos for France and now Flavia from Brazil. It was such an emotional night the other night in the team final.
Martins of Portugal scores 12.866 for her vault. Bars next for Philippa. Such a physical test, Chris, isn't it? These four pieces of amber eight is so vastly different.
Everything's so different, and this is a very different test for this gymnast.
Neermort now. She's the leader after the first piece, ahead of Simone Biles.
And she mounts with a beautiful layout somersault. Here comes the acrobatic series. Two layout somersaults. She looks very positive. Good splits. And there's the three elements joined. On the beam, the judges really want to see good rhythm, good dance. Change leg leap with the half turn. Smooth free walk over. You have to be so precise. The gymnasts need to put the arms same place every time. Simple spin. Nice control on the free cartwheel. You can really see the focus here. Nice and high on the toes. One big test. Flip to one, flip to two. Two and a half twist, just a little scurry, but she performed that very, very much better than qualification.
Well, bringing all of that grace and elegance that we saw on bars onto beam.
Big acrobatic series in the middle, two layout somersaults.
Yeah, and just that deduction on dismount. It's going to come down to tenths at the end of the day. At Takeda, over on vault now, 19 years old.
4-6 on the difficulty. One and a half twist in the Chenko. Just jumped out the lines, I think, a little bit. We'll see when we get on the replay. But it was tidy, efficient work.
Yeah, it's this constant battle with difficulty and how well you can execute it. And the, you know, you're trying to gain marks with the difficulty, but then you lose them with the execution. To 12.966.
Yeah, you see the 0.3 there for the bounce out. A shame that, because she didn't land out.
Yeah, yeah.
That's Gita in ninth. So across the floor, and Pauline Schaefer. Been around for a while now, 26 years old, and 19th in the all-around back in 2015.
Graceful on the beam. Beautiful to watch on the floor. Very expressive. Huge opening tumble, the double front somersault from the handspring. It looked like she got completely lost there in the twist. Had to compose herself, get back onto the floor. Very difficult spin work. Full twist this time, no problem. Got fabulous leap. Just a little bit off coming out of the spin. Well, a very expressive routine for Paulina Schaefer-Betts. Just a shame She got lost on that tumble. I don't know what happened there, guys.
Yeah, what a shame for Paulina. I think, yeah, it just the floor seemed to just meet her quicker than she was expecting. She took the rebound. It's very bouncy, that floor, Chris.
It is indeed.
6-3-3 after Flavia's fall.
Yeah, no, it is. It's a great floor for bouncing you up, but if you don't land precisely, it bounces you up again on the landing.
Well, Ellie Black next to go on bars from Canada. She's the fifth highest qualifier. She's in the bars final, so she's going to look to claim some tenths back here.
Good start. Oh, big combination there. Uprising to Kachev. Oh, but just a little bit long. You have to really go for these release and catches. You have to make sure you're going to catch at full stretch, but of course, full stretch and a centimetre is failure.
Well, she went all out there, as she always does, Ellie Black. They're now 28 years old, so vastly experienced on the world stage, and a torchbearer for Canada and their gymnastics program. So Ellie Black focuses in the second half of her routine. So she gets through it safely.
Good. Jaeger somersault, the front somersault. Down to the low bar. Here we go up with a half turn. That was very clean and easily done. Full pirouette, just takes the extra giant into the unusual dismount. The shoot front, the pike shoot front with half turn. Very unusual to see Ellie Black make a mistake like that.
Well, this is a 10-year anniversary from her first World Championships. She's had such a fantastic career. And we've seen a few of the gymnasts fall off the bars.
Well, this is the thing, isn't it? You see gymnasts falling, you look around the arena and you think to yourself, as a fifth highest qualifier, Jess is out. Hang on, I might be in with a shout.
Absolutely.
Here. And then you start really pushing it, and then before you know it, you're off. It's such a difficult mental challenge to get round the all-round, Chris.
It is a real mental challenge, and you have to be able to focus just on yourself. You have to not allow yourself to be taken in with what's happening around you.
Yeah.
You have to get in the zone, as it is.
Yeah, absolutely. Knowing Alice as well as you do, do you think it will have helped to not knowing and having the whole build-up of the day, or do you think?
Sometimes it does. You know, she's a gritty character. She's not one to go, oh, I haven't got a warm-up, I can't do it.
So Paulina Schaefer-Bett scores a 10.7 for floor.
Well, Matt, ask Christine after Alice has been on beam how she's feeling then. But talking of beam...
Yeah, and talking of falls.
She did the most amazing beam routine the other day.
So, Melanie de Jesus dos Santos took a fall on bars, but she'll focus in and brace yourselves for this.
I'm always so impressed with the front somersault mount. You have to launch yourself and hope you're in the straight line. And she was perfectly straight. Lovely straight-armed flip into the layout. Just a tiny readjustment. Nice and smooth in the leaps. You have to join two leaps. And the judges have to consider whether you've joined them. Here's two more. Oh, and she just let the back leg slide out sideways. But that was well composed. It's a difficult spin. And of course, once you've had a little bit of a wobble, it's easily possible to get a bit rattled. Much better rhythm now. She's keeping the movement going. Lovely use of the whole body in the dance work. can really see the big focus. Double pike, a super dismount, and actually not a terrible routine, but there were wobbles.
But some fantastic recoveries in there, and that's the key. Stay on, keep the tenths.
Well, she showed great strength of character coming back from the bars, which was a very uncharacteristic fall. Then to go onto the beam, to pick yourself back up, and it just shows true grit and character of these gymnasts.
Absolutely.
And no doubt another 6 months or so and to be a different gymnast for the Olympics.
Irina Kishin, 16 years old, the youngest competitor in this women's all-round final.
Well, it's a five for the difficulty, so it's a big vault. Double twist in Yurchenko. Actually, for a little gymnast, she really did zip that off the top.
Holding her own with the best out there.
Yeah, that was a good vault for a little gymnast. She lifts up well. It's a little bit of a uncomfortable landing. I did wonder, actually, if she'd hurt her foot slightly, but I think she just sees the floor quite late.
Well, a very respectable 13-8. Irina Kishi of Japan. So what are the judges going to award Ellie Black after her fall on bars? She will get another chance at the bars. She's in the bars final over the weekend. Thora Thorstotje of the Netherlands, the last to vault in this rotation.
We saw her do a huge floor routine and a pretty decent vault as well. Little bit piped down. When the chest is down and the feet land, that's when the judges get their pens out. But a good double twist, good shape in the air.
Yeah, I think she's improved a little bit on the vault, Christine, just upped the difficulty a bit. I'm sure she used to compete a 1.5, so I've been working on this. Wraps in. Yeah, a little bit down with the chest, but good score. Nevertheless, 13.833.
She had a top 10 finish at the Rio Olympics. Nimor scores 13-3. She drops from first into third. Now that will be behind Simone Biles and Shailese Jones, whose bars you haven't seen. But she scored a 14-6-3-3. Sure, Alice Kinsella's been yet. She'll be last to go on bars. Well, we're going to stick with floor, and this is Alice D'Amato of Italy. She qualified 15th. She's a great gymnastic family.
Yes.
Sister.
Twin, one of a twin. And they've both been part of a very strong Italian team over this last 4 years.
Well, Alice scored a 13-4 in qualification.
Very dramatic. Difficult spin to start, but fantastic control. Big opening tumble, using every inch of the floor. Oh, what a shame. Just got a kick back from the floor, chest too low. Has to really focus and concentrate now. Come on, you've got to absorb the landing. Much better, the double twist. Well, what a shiv. Alice D'Amato there was so close to being a fabulous routine.
Similar thing happening there, though, to Paulina Schaefer-Betz. I mean, interesting, this floor and how the gymnasts are working with it and coping with it.
Yeah, it's there's springs underneath it, and the springs take you up, but unless you really bend your legs and kill the landing.
And her chest was really low down then, so she was nearly at 90 degrees, so the problem is the rebound's going, which will force your hips to come up in the air. Much better there on the double twist. Can you see she's landing vertically, so you can absorb it through the legs?
Obviously different to what they'll be training on. Melanie De Jesus dos Santos scores a 13.466 for beam. What a shame on bars, being her first piece of apparatus as well. So, as you can see, she's not having the happiest of times out there.
It's a long way round the competition when you muck your first piece up.
Hard job for the coach, that, Christine, isn't it?
It is.
When your gymnast's fallen off, I mean, what do you say to yourself? And the thing is, De Santos has been in that position many a time.
Ellie Black, 12.133 after her fall from bars. Again, all these stories of what could have been and all the build-up, and we're at the World Championships, and when it doesn't go your way, you've had a whole day of build-up and a whole year's worth of work. Rebecca Andrade, one of the favourites in this all-round competition.
And she floats up to the high bar. Lovely pirouette. Big Kachev. Big Paxalto. And with the half turn. Have to do a forward element as well. Here hers comes. Jaeger somersault. Those long arms swooped out. Clean on the turn. Full pirouette, nicely done. Full twisting double back.
Oh.
That's how you land.
Oh, she is such a class act.
She's going to push Simone Biles all the way.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Shailese Jones, they're all watching her. I tell you, this is going to be very, very close. And in the absence of Jessica Gadarova, what is the top three going to look like?
Well, I think what impresses me most about this gymnast is she just seems to grow with competition throughout the season. And she's very accomplished. She knows exactly what she needs to do. And you were talking, Christine, before about, you know, concentrate on what you're doing. Don't get drawn into everything else. And that's exactly what she does. Phenomenal.
Sarah Voss on vault. 4-2, keeping it simple.
Simple and stylish, rules the way, and it certainly was that. It absolutely floated in the air, the full twist in the Yuchenko.
You certainly would expect that execution score to be in the nines. Very precise.
It always fascinates me, this relationship between difficulty and execution. Because, as you can see, look, 13.4 is a good vault score. And she's opted for a simpler vault, but just went for execution.
Yep, 9-2 for execution.
If you think about Biles, she gets a 9-3, 9-4 with a vault at 5-6-6.
Yeah.
And that's why Simone Biles is so dominant. She can execute the biggest skills. That's simple as that.
Alice D'Amato at 12.5. She's in 16th. That moment in the corner of the floor. Well, Rebecca Andrade, 14.5. It's exactly what she needed. Doing her best to try and retain this all-round title that she won last year. She took a silver in the all-round at the Olympics. Chance to see Alice Kinsella with her second piece of apparatus. And she can swing the bars, Chris.
I know she hadn't really warmed up in the back gym, so hopefully she's had a feel out here.
Well, huge pressure on Alice Kinsella. She's in for Jessica Gadarova as a reserve, and she will take the opportunity.
Lovely handstand. High into the front somersault, the Jaeger somersault. This is a difficult combination. Kachev, immediate pack salto, smoothly down. Good handstand again, has to swing high. She's got a ginga here, caught well. Now, she hasn't pirouetted yet. Now it has to come. And up into the dismount. Oh, well saved, Alice. She was just a little bit wonky at the end of the pirouette, and she had to fight for it.
But she was through.
She was.
You said to me beforehand, Chris, I said, what can you hope for? And you said, I just wanted to go clean. Well, listen, she's got two through.
She has. It's been quite a hard year after all the excitement of Commonwealth, World Championships, European Games last year. And it's been quite a come down this year. So I think all the gymnasts who did those three majors have had a lot of work, like emotionally, to do to get back to this level of competing at World Championships. Well done, Alice. You could have sat that down very easily.
She fought, didn't she?
She did.
But that's what Alice Kinsella is, a fighter.
That's right.
Marina Esposito of Italy.
Lovely start there, straight into some of the lovely acrobatic work. She did a fabulous beam routine the other day in the team competition. And for such a young gymnast, performs with such maturity. Look at the control there on the single leg spin. Down onto the beam. Gymnasts, part of the requirements, have to perform elements. Valdez. Difficult leap series into the flick. Working with a nice tempo, plenty of confidence. Free cartwheel. Gymnast have to perform dance choreography. Great routine so far. Big concentration, stands up, big double back. Oh, what a shame. So near. Big double bite back dismount.
And she just cannot help but show how disappointed she is with herself.
Well, it was going so well. 12.866 is the result.
Would have been a very big score.
It would, yeah. On to floor. And this is Georgia Godwin. From Australia, she qualified in 14th. She took a gold in the all-round at the Commonwealth Games.
And here she's been part of the Australian team that have qualified for the Olympic Games. First time in a while for them. So they will have been celebrating. That was a good spin to start. Just a little step out, but sky-high double front summy. Ooh, and super double straight. Just dropped the leg a little early to get the credit for the spin. Nice twist in combination. big double pike, very good landing. Well, it was a nicely balanced routine, but just an error right on that first tumble.
Yeah, real shame for Georgia, such a fun character. I remember interviewing her actually after that Commonwealth Games gold, that she was so full of joy. About 12.333. Again, the gymnasts are finding it a challenge, this floor. There's no doubt about that.
No, they are, aren't they? I think this hopefully is just warm up. 13.6 for Alice on the bars.
Pleased with that?
Yes, considering the two, she must have lost at least 0.3, if not 0.5, on the dismount.
So here are the standings after two, halfway round. Simone Biles leads ahead of Andrade. Charlize Jones is in third. Alice Kinsella in sixth at the moment. Ondina Champon of Great Britain in 14th. Flavia Sareva way down the field from where she would have expected. And those gymnasts that have had a bit of a nightmare with the floor. You can see Alicia D'Amato 18th, Pauline Schaefer-Betts down in 24th. But Beth, I don't know if you can hear me in the studio, but just a word on this floor and the challenge that you have as a gymnast, sort of coping with it and adapting to the different floors as you sort of move around the international gymnastic competition circuit. And, you know, how you do it as a gymnast, as a floor world champion. What did you do?
So obviously, it's they don't get long to prepare on that floor. They do have a floor in the back gym that they're training on the podium. But also during competition, you've got that adrenaline, you've got that extra buzz, and it gives you that extra little bit of power, and it can be quite hard. And we are
ready for the third. Yeah, do you? I guess with the bigger competitions, do you try and get on the floors of that particular brand and work with those springs?
The gymnasts have, we've had a Spieth floor at Lillishall. The British team have been training on the Spieth floor certainly for the last 3 weeks or so. And it's quite a little bit different. They have found it's made their ankles a bit sore. It's just a different consistency.
Well, here is the current leader. I think she's just getting things set because Simone Biles will be the first to go in this rotation, the third rotation. Two pieces left then in this women's all-round final. The highest qualifier, Simone Biles, on the piece. She won an Olympic bronze medal on the Olympics, where she said goodbye for 18 months.
One little hesitation at the end of the mount. But no hesitation at all with that first series. And she works with such good pace and tempo. And it makes you feel that she's mastered the apparatus, and the judges have a particular deduction for lack of mastery. Well, Simone doesn't get that deduction. Lovely free walkover joined to two jumps. And as soon as the feet joined into the flip to the two layouts, really positive. She's so powerful and fast, and she brings that to the beam work as well. There are the sideways elements. This is something new. The judges want to see side elements as well. Such a strong landing. And she's already now at the dismount. It's such a dismount as well. Watch here. One flip, two flip, up. Full twisting, double back. Chest looking at the beam. Just fantastic.
It's like she's in another stratosphere. I mean, she's come back and she hasn't just, you know, come back to say hello. She's come back to emphatically win this thing.
Well, she just oozes confidence on this piece of apparatus. There's not many gymnasts that go on there. And at the start, you could see she was a bit aggravated with herself and used that determination to finish the routine with such confidence and style.
Well, Ondina Champon of Great Britain is at the end of the vault runway. She scored a 14.3 in qualification. She got silver in the all-round at the Commonwealth Games. She can't half vault. Ondine. Now is the time to do it.
Harness the power, wraps in. The double twist in the Yurchenko. That's a cracking vault. That'd be well into the 14s.
Beautiful stuff from Ondine Champon.
You know, it's nice to see the gymnast out there smiling.
Well, she was very much looking forward to today, her first ever world all-around final. And look, there's not much wrong with that vault, is there?
She looks very, very at home amongst this company. Nemo, the gymnast that was leading after the first rotation. She went to beam, managed to hang on to 10th there. So she's not out of the running for a medal yet. And no doubt she'll have a graceful floor as well.
She's a young gymnast, just 16 years of age. And before COVID, I was in France for a big international of juniors, and she was competing for France there. But since then, she's changed. She had dual nationality and has changed to work for Algeria.
Well, what a moment it would be if Algeria could get on the medal podium. Certainly be a first. Kelia Nemo. Next on floor.
Oh, big opening tumble walk out from the 1.5 into the triple twist. Well, control the leap series. One of the requirements. The double Arabian did well to hold that. Great use of the fingertips, showing good extension. Oh, a little bit of a kickback again on the double back. Another very controlled performance.
Yeah, she's so expressive, isn't she, with her gymnastics? And I guess those lovers of artistic gymnastics and the artistry of it, Chris, I mean, this... That's exactly what she brings. She's got the difficulty, but also the artistry.
Yes, and she's precise in her work. This was a very good landing, because you really don't get a chance to see, and you don't have a chance to make much mistake.
14-4, 3-3 for Simone Biles. Continues that lead. Floor to go. Just one more piece between her and another all-round title. 14-1-3-3 for Ondine Champon. Moves up into second for now, but there's a lot of gymnastics left to go in this rotation, and indeed the rest of this women's all-round final at the World Championships. Paulina Schäfer-Betz going for a 4-6 difficulty, so that means that the whole vault is marked out of 14.6. To improve on her performance from floor.
Good, powerful run. Front handspring, front somersault with a half turn. We don't see so many of those vaults, but that was a very nice performance. Knees locked together, handspring up, very tidy vault altogether, that. Because often when you see these front somersault vaults, the knees are pulled apart to increase rotation, but that was very clean.
Lee Yun-seol of Korea. Also doing a 4-6.
Well, these vaulters are coming thick and fast. Full twist in the Yushchenko. Now, wasn't very far from the table, even though it was quite nice in the air, so it will be deducted for just a little bit of lack of length, Chris, would you say?
Yes, I would think so, and a little bit soft in the knees. We're going to see a replay here. She twists very late, which is good, but just a little bit of a knee bend as she went.
It's 12.733 for Lee Yun-seol. Pops her into fifth momentarily. And Nemo scores a 12.7 for Floor.
Difficulty down a little bit, just 5 in difficulty.
It's going to lower her down the standings. Naomi Visser is next up, and talk about elegance and artistry. Well, enjoy this.
But also enjoy this whip, triple twist, punch front. Great opener. Nicely held. All the spins, you have to complete the double spin with the leg held up. Mirroring the music with her movement so well. 2.5 twist into punch front. Have to have a series of leaps. Those were very nicely performed. Has very good musicality, hits the music beats. Good, strong double back as well. Very cleverly controlled routine that.
Yeah, she performs with a real style of her own. Beautiful to watch. Fabulous music choice as well. And we talk about working with the music and selling a story. It certainly does that.
Well, she was in 11th going into this. Rotation, one to go. She could well move up the standings there. Paulina Schaefer-Betz after vault has gone into 9th. Still a lot of gymnastics left to go in this rotation. So Flavia Sereva of Brazil next on beam. Was 5th at the Olympics back in Rio on this piece of apparatus.
Flip mount into a jump. She's always been a gymnast who's promised so much on beam. I remember that Olympics in Rio so well. She'd qualified with one of the top scores, and this was the big moment for an Olympic medal. And the pressure was just too much. But this is good, mature work. A lot more experience now. Here's the acrobatics. The backflip, the layout, somersault. And that's one of the leaps she's quite renowned for. The change leg ring with the head right off the beam. And there we see it again from the better angle, and you can just see how much you have to take. She has to take her head back. Side somersault. Backwards, forwards, sideways somersaults, as well as leaps and jumps have to be included. Eight elements make up your difficulty. One of those elements is your dismount. So it needs to be good, it needs to be high. It certainly was that.
What a dismount that was. That is exactly how you do it. 26 years old now, and putting all of that experience, Chris, that you're talking about into play here.
Well, that's the Flavia that we're used to seeing. It performed so well in the team competition. We know she's a gymnast with huge experience, great potential. It's a pity she's that far from the bars, because she would certainly been in the mix.
14.033, same as what she scored in qualification.
Just goes to show, that was a big score.
Naomi Visser, for her floor routine, scores a 13.533.
You see her difficulty up at 5.7. She's not a big, huge tumbler, but it's clever tumbles.
Georgia Godwin at the end of the vault runway. With the gold on this piece as well. At the Commonwealth Games. So yes, 23 going up into this piece, looking to vault the way up the standards here.
Well, very dynamic gymnast. Oh, fabulous vault in the Sukahara, a half on into the somersault with a 1.5 twist. Blind landing, but absolutely spot on control. Great vault.
So across the beam with Rebecca Andrade, currently in second place. Just 0.2 behind Simone Biles, hoping to retain this all-round title that she won last year.
Little wobble, but very smooth on the leaps. Smoothly and quickly into the backflip and layout somersault. There are deductions if you take too long a pause before elements. And another gymnast who works with great rhythm. I do think this is a piece of apparatus that as the gymnasts get a little bit older, they understand more. And she managed to pull the hips round square. And many of them still find the spin quite taxing.
Gosh, it's quiet out there, isn't it?
It is. Now, she's done very well. She's had a few little wobbles, but she doesn't take long, straight into the double pike. She's so powerful. That's such an easy dismount for her.
Well, that was a super beam routine. You could cut the tension with a knife on that one. Well, oh, my word.
You were talking about being quiet, Matt. I just noticed, actually, how close the photographers are at the side of the beam, and you could probably hear the photographers clicking away at the lens. Mm.
Georgia Godwin, 13.6 for her vault.
Good solid beam from Andrade.
It was, and it was needed as well. She's hanging on in there in second place with floor to go. A good piece for her. Alicia D'Amato, her third piece is vault. She scored a 14 in qualies.
Well, a 5 for difficulty. The little twist, Yurchenko, that was pretty good.
Well, it's beautiful, wasn't it?
You really do need at least a 5 difficulty in this level of competition if you want to challenge the top 10. And that was a great vault.
She's a really classy gymnast, but she hasn't had a great championships at all here. She's made different mistakes.
Incredible rotation off the top, though, with this twist as she wraps it in.
Really very good vaulting.
You can see there from the replay the amount of force that goes through the knees on these gymnasts.
13.933 is Alice's reward. She's hanging around the top 10. Morgane Arsec-Rima of France. She's in the all-round final at the Europeans last year. She came seventh there.
And worked so well for her team. Look at that beautiful double twisting, double tuck. And straight front somersault into double back. Just fighting to keep inside the square. Good strong leap. Full twisting double back, that was a better landing. Very clean and precise with her arm movements. Strong with the tumbles. Interesting, she finished with a leap series. A really strong floor routine, that.
Yeah, but quite a bizarre choice of music, I thought, didn't you, Craig?
Yeah, I thought it was an interesting choice of music.
Andrade, 13.5 for Beam.
Quite a few little errors there, Christine, you picked up on. I mean, it's better to take the little errors than take the fall. But, yeah, you need to get up to the 14s if you're going to get anywhere near Biles.
Well, Biles has stretched ahead now. She was 0.2 ahead of Andrade. Now she's over a mark ahead of her with floor to go. Very, very strong piece of apparatus for Biles. I'm just hoping we get to see Alice Kinsella, just to let you know we're not in control of these pitches here.
Oh,
they heard
there you
us.
Go.
They heard us. So here we go then. Alice Kinsella was in sixth, going up to this third of four pieces of apparatus. European beam champion. One piece to go after this. It's women's all-round world final.
Leap on the end of the beam. Good free walk over. Smoothly through the two jumps. Now, this is a very big series, and this is the crunch of the routine, really. Three cartwheel, layout. Well done, Alice. Has to keep the rhythm of the routine going. That's the sideways elements. Big leap series that it's important to perform. One leap, two leaps, cleanly through. Now she hasn't had a spin. She's got the spin down low on the beam. Quite difficult at the end of the routine like this. And there's her low to the beam section, the backward roll. Now keep your focus, Alice. That's 10 seconds to dismount. Big round of up, 2.5. Well done, Alice. I couldn't be more delighted for her.
Oh, absolutely fantastic stuff. And what a performance she's putting in this all-round final, Chris.
Oh, I'm so pleased. I see that from her every day in training. She so deserves to do it under pressure.
Well, just floor to go. And I'm not saying that she can relax, but she'll be pleased to have got Beam out the way.
Absolutely. There we are.
Oh, Alice, a 13-4-3-3. Another great score. And so wonderful to see that smile. And I can tell you that Christine still has the same look on her face. Well, on to another of the medal contenders. Shailese Jones of the USA will be last to go on beam. She's in the beam final. She qualified in fifth with 13.4. So she might just be able to match Alice.
Well, she's a very positive gymnast on this piece of apparatus. Very graceful as well. Look at the extension in the arms. That's a very difficult skill, the standing Arabian. Really going to pile the pressure on a teammate. It's a difficult series. Flick, flick, into the straight back somersault. Solid as a rock. Down to the beam. What I like about this gymnast is she has a real pace about the routine. Fluidity. Got some great choreography. Free cartwheel. Full spin, just that little adjustment. Now, big concentration. Flick to one, flick to two. Double pipe back, sticks to landing. Well, under pressure, that was a fantastic routine.
Absolutely huge. This top group are really pulling out all of the stops.
Wow, she's got such a lot in this routine, but she is a gymnast who makes gymnastics look easy, doesn't she? That's so difficult, that acrobatic series.
Thora, Thora's daughter of the Netherlands now on bars.
And quite unusual, the shot coming from the clear circle and the pack, Salto back down. You can only use one type of root skill, like the toe on, like that three times. So she's used it twice. And that means you have to have a bit more variety to your work, but this is swinging very nicely. Half turn into the Jaeger somersault, the front somersault straddled. Good half turn there. Full twisting double back. Thorsdottir is looking very strong.
Yeah, that was really beautiful. What the floor that she had there, it was very graceful through the air and the way she worked the bars.
She is just a very graceful gymnast, whatever she's doing.
Yeah, Thorsdottir will move up the ranks without question after that.
So good handstand work as well. 13.433.
She goes into fifth behind Alice Kinsella.
She's in third place in the all-around ranking now. And there's a score for Shailese Jones, 14.066.
Chu Jian of China on floor. He's the Chinese all-round champion. And another gymnast that's just 16 years old in this final.
That was a very well-controlled spin. Good full twist in double back, just that little step forward. Front walk out, that's one of the requirements, into the double twist. Not the most difficult pass, but performed very well. Lovely leap there, the head right back to the foot. Showing great flexibility in the leap there as well. Good technique in the double back, performed very well, knees locked together. Beautiful perform routine there.
Well, she was in fifth, stepping up to floor. Is that going to move her up towards the medals?
Well, it was certainly a very clean performance. We've seen the gymnasts from China struggle on four, and this was a much, much more confident and competent performance. Lovely height on the front summary walkout.
Well, yeah, 13.166 puts her one position away from bronze with one piece of apparatus left to go in this women's all-round final.
Well, if you think about the difficulty of 5.1, Biles has a difficulty of 6.4. So you're 1.3 behind already.
That is the huge
that's the advantage she has.
Charlize Jones scores a 14.066 for her beam. Big score, big score. So this is how things are looking with one to go. Simone Biles leads the field ahead of Charlize Jones, her teammate. Rebecca Andrade currently in that bronze medal place. Alice Kinsella in sixth. Ondina Champon has moved up into ninth. Wonderful if she could stay inside that top 10. Alicia D'Amato, 14th.
Alice Kinsella, sixth.
The two Germans.
That's the top eight.
Sarah Voss and Pauline Schaefer-Betz, 23rd and 24th.
Everything will be
so this top group then are moving the on to floor, and no doubt this is where those medals are going to be decided. Biles will be last to go as the top qualifier, so all eyes will be on her.
Yeah, well, she's just under a mark advantage over a teammate. So she'll be feeling pretty confident going on to that last piece of apparatus. And we know she's probably got half a dozen floor routines that she can utilise. Is she going to go all out for difficulty? Is she going to play it safe? I think as a return, it's about getting through the routine.
Interestingly, though, Chris, I mean, there's only less than 0.2 between second and third here. Yeah, so the silver could go either way between Andrade and Charlize Jones.
And if you look at Simone Biles in qualification, scored six, was awarded 6.7 for difficulty, but Charlize Jones was only 5.7, one whole mark between them.
Yeah.
And Andrade 6.1, so
it's going to be very, very close if qualification's anything to go by. But Flavia Sareva takes to the floor. She's fourth highest qualifier for the floor final. So this will be beautiful, graceful, and full of fireworks.
A little bit of a kickback from the floor, but well within the lines. Bit of Brazilian flair. That's, oh, a we're going to see a big second tumble. She's done well to stand up from that double layout. Real ankle cruncher, that one. That's better, the 1.5 twist into the straight full. Come on, stand it up. Obviously in a bit of pain, opted for a straight back. Flavia Sarajeva from Brazil finishes her competition. Probably not the way she would have wanted. I hope she's okay.
Well, she was such a big part of that Brazilian historic medal. A real shame for her in this all-round competition. Well, Nemo was in fifth, stepping up to vault, and this will be a high-scoring event for her.
But not the most difficult vault, just a 4.2. She needs to perform it almost perfectly. Little hop forwards, just the full twisting straight, Yushchenko.
Well, really interesting, actually, because she's performed so well. And from the top there, it's a little bit snatched. I think give her another 6 months, if she gets a double twist in for Paris, could be a real contender.
Absolutely. Lee Yunsu of Korea finishes her all-round competition on bars. She was 21st in the all-round in the Olympics, Tokyo.
Lovely stoop in, a little bit late on that full turn. But the stoop, such a difficult skill. Pak Solto immediately shap half. That's good use of the swing. Stoop half. High into the pike, Jaeger somersault. Stalled a full turn. Straight into the dismount. Nice routine, that. Very efficient.
I enjoyed that. It was everything you want, really, from a bar routine. And it was through quick, Chris.
It was, and it had loads of energy. I mean, the speed of swing is one of the things that marks how good a gymnast you are. Mm. Those stoops are very difficult, and they're given a lot more marks than if you do it with your feet on the bar. Lovely and high in the somersault. And I really liked, she whipped that full twist in, didn't she? She was cleanly round and out.
And lovely knees together, actually. Sometimes you see the legs a little bit tatty, but that is great bar work. Well done.
Nemo scores at 12.766. So down on her qualification vault score. So not this year, but we shall keep an eye and look forward to the future.
Pretty impressive, really. 16 years old, come out without a mistake.
Ooh, 12-2. Osareva. And we join Ellie Black on floor now. She was second in the all-around world final back in 2017. Still going strong. And capable of mid-13s on this piece, that's for sure.
And a very interesting floor routine, a little bit different. Two and a half twist into double pike. Wow, that's some combination. Really working and expressing the music. Full twisting front into double tuck. powerfully into the leaps. Almost a little bit of theatre in this. Oh, super double twisting front forwards. Well, a really expressive, exciting floor routine. Unfortunately, little errors on most of the tumble landings.
Melanie de Jesus dos Santos finishes her competition on vault. She hasn't had a great all-round final.
She hasn't, but she's got a bronze medal from the team competition. And look at that vault! Absolutely fantastic. And you know what? She probably hasn't had the all-round competition. You can see the disappointment, but actually, the signs of greatness there for next year. And imagine being in your own country to all-round medal. I think she's a real chance.
She certainly seems a lot more settled now. She's training with Simone in the States.
Rina Kishi.
Japan strong on the balance beam. Oh, just a little wobble, but she's been very clean with the free walkover and the two jumps. And another of these difficult leaps where you take your head off the beam. Strong backflip and layout somersault. Now she needs some nice dance work. She's packed the difficulty in, but the judges wish to see expressive work as well for a good score. And that's better, traveling along the beam with some tempo. Nicely done. Good, strong, double tuck dismount. Well done. Actually, we've seen great beam work today.
Strong piece, yes, we have. Nice to see it as well in the final. 13-7-6-6 for Lee Yunsuo of Korea. Yeah, it's never nice to see victims of beam in an all-round,
no,
is it?
No.
You want to see gymnasts win the title, not lose it.
Absolutely.
Well, 12.9 for Ellie Black on the floor. No doubt she'll be back to fight another day.
Rebecca Andrade rounds up her all-round competition on floor. She's in second at the moment. It's going to be very, very close with Shailese Jones.
Well, this is a real crowd pleaser. Big opening tumble, full twist, Walker into pulling back out. Full twisting, double straight for the second pass. Absolutely phenomenal tumbling. Looking right into the judges' eyes, full of expression. Now that was super control. When you talk about working with the music, this is what they mean. No hesitation in the corner. Double layout for the third tumble. beautiful height in the split leap. She can dance, she can tumble, she's got it all. Has she a bit left at the end? Oh, too much power. Oh. Well, that was absolutely fabulous. And Biles might take the title, but she has pushed her all the way through the competition.
She has. Well, Andrade is in third at the moment. How costly will that last tumble be? She's trying to catch Shailese Jones. There's just 0.2 between them. Shailese in qualification had a slightly lower floor score. So what a battle there is.
Well, I do think that was a fabulous floor routine. That's my favourite routine, I think, of the championships.
Chu Chi-Wan of China. Again, a simpler vault here, just 4.4 on the difficulty. But it was efficient. It was executed with style. Well, someone who's been having a quiet competition, but very competent, is Thora Thor's daughter of Netherlands. What can she do here on beam? Incredibly graceful gymnast.
Oh, and she did well not to fall then. Didn't get her hands right on the beam. Sets the spin. That's such a difficult spin, and she works straight out of it and into another one. Good combination. Spin, leap, spin. She is good at the acrobatics. Yes, she is. The backflip and layout somersault. Always elegant, always supple, good movement throughout the body. The judges want to see whole body movement, not just arms and legs, and she is very good in that area. Moves the head as well, and it's actually very difficult to dance on the beam like this. Gives some expression as well as movement. Free cartwheel. So she's built the difficulty, she's fulfilled the requirements. She's joined leaps and acrobatics. Two and a half twists, what a competition she has had. Really impressive.
Well, that's got to be good enough for a top 10 finish, Matt.
Absolutely. Chi-Wan scores 13.2. Says first at the moment, but there's still a lot of gymnasts to go in this final. Rina Kishi scores 13.533. Such respect between all these gymnasts.
I was just going to say there's a great camaraderie down there.
Right, well, this score is key. 14.066 for Rebecca Andrade. So she's on 56.766.
And without that step out, that'd have been a huge 56.
Great Britain's Alice Kinsella. With her fourth piece of apparatus, she came in as a reserve. Didn't know she was going to be competing until 20 minutes before this final. And what a performance we've seen from Alice.
Can she keep it right through to the end? This is a very big series. The 1.5 walkout into the triple twist. Very nicely done. And this is a difficult tumble. Round off flip, 2.5 twist, punch front. Good spin. Lovely split on the leaps. Cleanly round the full turn then. One big tumble left. Needs to give it plenty of power. We haven't seen a double somersault yet, so she has to put this in the last tumble. Double pike, very good. Well done, Alice. A clean competition. Perhaps it was as well not to know before you came.
Oh, well, huge congratulations to Alice Kinsella, who looks like she really enjoyed that experience. Goodness me, she stepped up, and my word, does she display strength in depth in British gymnastics.
Well, I'm glad she's put that together. Christine got her nails done yesterday, and I think she's bitten the heads off of Jim in this competition. So we're going to have to get your nails done again. But, I mean, that was a big opening tumble, the walk out into the triple twist. And, you know, sometimes if you're just thrown in at the last minute, you can really relax. You have nothing to lose. And what a performance she's put together.
Well, Thor's daughter smiling as brightly, and I'm not surprised. 13.566.
Time for a little dance.
Party time. It's all good for those that have finished. Manila Esposito of Italy. Strong volta.
Well, another gymnast that could get into the top 10. And we've been impressed with lovely 1.5 twist there, Yurchenko.
She did such a good beam and then fell on the dismount. That was a great shame.
She's put together a great championships, actually.
Well, it's a demonstration of real quality, isn't it? The year before the Olympics. It's going to be tough competition, that's for sure, in Paris.
It is, and that really is a textbook vault. Pops off the top, lands on the middle line.
Esposito scores 13.766 in six, with a few gymnasts left to go. Certainly in the top group as well. Well, to go all the way around without a fall when you're not expecting to compete is an unbelievably fine achievement.
Well, I'm very delighted and really hope Jess is okay.
13.233 for Alice Kinsella. She'll be well inside the top 10, that's for sure. Well, this is going to be a huge routine. If Shailese Jones wants silver, she needs to better her qualification score on floor. She needs 13.834 to match Andrade, who's currently in that silver medal position at the moment.
Needs every ounce of concentration. Some big tumbles, double twisting, double back. Up on the toes, no problem. Beautiful control in the spins. Front walk out. Oh, she did so well there. Legs buckled on that straight front full twist. Almost Cirque du Soleil style music. got to concentrate now. Full twist in, double back. Just a little bit soft on the knees on the landing. Come on. As artistic as ever, not without a little mishap in the middle. I don't know what went wrong, but...
Well, she did incredibly well to recover from it, that's for sure, and to continue that tumble. This is going to be very, very close. I think it's enough for a medal, but what colour will it be?
It really was very uncharacteristic. There, the beautiful double twisting, double back. But when she came back the next way, she really had to go from dead, didn't she?
Into a double back. So I think she'd be down a little bit on the start score.
Well, Alice D'Amato, a 20-year-old from Italy, a European bars champion. That's where she finishes here, on bars.
She's not had a great championship. She's a really good bar worker, and that was smooth as you like, that first series. And this looked very unusual, the Kachev into the full turning pack. She's swinging very nicely now. She hops across the bar to have enough room to be able to do the turn and then the invert with another full turn into the double front dismount with the half turn. At last, she says, I get through this bar routine, because she's made mistakes in the team competitions.
Yeah, it's been a real battle, this championships. But again, look, she's thinking, thank God that's over. But the Italians are fabulous bar workers. That's some very difficult work into the invert and then into this big dismount, the double front somersault with the half turn. At last, I think she's thinking.
I think so. Oh, and look at that score.
14.666 for Alice D'Amato. Says third at the moment, but there's still scores to come in.
She's certainly climbed up the ranks, though, considering she had a fall on floor.
What are the judges going to do with Shailese Jones's score? She knows it could have been better. Just running it through in her mind. Taking their time, that's for sure. They want to get it right.
Well, interesting. Shailese Jones didn't start with her number on her back for beam, which is actually a violation, which can pick up a penalty of up to 0.3.
I think some of them have fallen off during the competition, haven't they? Because if they
land and roll out.
Yeah, and on the beam, you have to go down onto your whole body on the beam. So it's been quite difficult.
Shailese Jones, 13.4. She's behind Andrade.
Well, that was costly, that second tumble. And she knew it, didn't she, when she finished?
She looked a little uncertain before she started it, I do have to say.
Well, here we go. The world is watching. The world welcomes back Simone Biles. And they all want to see her crowned yet again, all-around champion of the world.
Full of personality right from the start. Watch the big, big tumble. Double straight with twist. Now, this is a huge tumble. Full twist, walk out into double twisted, double back. It's unreal, that. Great energy, look at the height on that leap. And another massive tumble coming up here. Double straight with the half turn. Lands perfectly. And just tripped over her foot as she was going into some leaps. She managed to not fall over. double straight to finish.
Well,
what a fabulous routine.
We all didn't expect that, and Simone didn't expect it either.
I was going to say, Simone least of all expected it, but I think she'd already done her leap series, so she'll just have a little bit of a deduction. She won't actually lose the leaps.
Well, she had a mark ahead of the rest of the world going into floor. The question is, how much of a margin will she have?
Well, she needs a 12.9 to take the title.
Surely she's done enough.
Easily done. I mean, she had a little giggle at herself, didn't she, on the floor, thinking, what was I doing then? But that was absolute, what a return to competition.
Absolutely phenomenal. And there it is.
It actually will be a fair bit of a deduction. She kept her hands off the floor, but it was, you know, it was a trip up, wasn't it?
And there's a bit of criticism about this gymnast cannot entertain people. She had the crowd clapping along. I just think,
come on,
phenomenal.
Who
are those?
Well, if they don't, that doesn't entertain them, my word.
No, that was super routine.
And the last tumble to finish on a double layout.
Look, she's almost doing a double straight on the way up. It's absolutely incredible. She is just another level.
Oh, she is completely, especially on floor.
That's the Biles. I mean, one of her skills, she's got five, so why not throw one in?
I just love how much she's enjoying it now. I really do. She's going to be as intrigued as the rest of us of what the score is.
Well, I don't think we've ever seen that on a floor before.
I think it'll be enough. I think, you know, 12.9, it will be enough. She could have fallen over and got 12.9.
Well, Andrade in that silver medal place at the moment, potentially.
Well, she's in the gold medal place
so
far.
Well, she is, yeah, but I'm just thinking ahead with Simone thinking, just literally talking to her coach. I don't know what happened.
Test for the judges.
I know, no, they're all having the right good conflab, no doubt. Well, the work that she has put in to get back to this level, I mean, she's arguably better than she was when she left. It's gold for Simone Biles! 14.533! She takes the all-around title in the style of the champion that she is. Simone Biles is back on top of the world as the world all-around champion. And Rebecca Andrade hands over the golden baton.
What is my score?
She takes silver. And, oh. Charlize Jones takes the bronze, but it's time to celebrate. And what a women's all-round final we've seen here. Rebecca Andrade, along with Flavia Ferreira, hoist the Brazilian flag, and it's time to samba. But Simone Biles is yet again the all-round queen. It's her sixth all-around title, and what a joy it was to witness.
What a privilege to see this gymnast perform. She really is the most dominant female gymnast, and I've been in gymnastics a long time, that I have ever seen.
Simone Biles finishes on a total of 58.399. And it is just so wonderful to see her back where she belongs. Charlize Jones, a bronze medalist. She took the silver last year. But there's more gold to come, no doubt, for Simone Biles at these World Championships.
And what about that for Alice Kinsella, finishing in seventh place. 20 minutes notice, Ondine Champon, 13th, great results for the British girls at the World Championships.
So did I. I said, uh-oh. I was going to try to do my double layout and then do it again.
Fascinating just to hear her talk there, saying she was going to do the tumble again. Well, there is your champion yet again, Simone Biles. Welcome back.
Well, Christine, what a night of gymnastics. This young lady never ceases to amaze us.
Absolutely fantastic night. Wonderful gymnastics.
Confirmation of the results. Simone Biles takes her sixth world title. Rebeca Andrade of Brazil takes the silver. Shalice Jones of the United States in fourth. Chu Chuyan of China fourth. Elise D'Amato had a great competition, finishing in fifth. Alice Kinsella, seventh, and Ondine Achampon, Great Britain, in 13th.
Well, an absolutely fantastic evening, and I'm sure we'll want to hear from the girls.
Thank you. I am with Alice and Ondine. Alice, I'm going to come to you first. Seventh in the world. How long did you have before you knew you had to go on and compete your first apparatus?
So I only went there to do little bits and bobs like stretching, conditioning, and then I went off to get my foot rubbed. And then my coach came over and was like, Alice, you need to get your leotard on straight away, because I think it happened on vault and I just need to get it on straight away. So.
How did you feel?
I was a bit stressed. I didn't really know what to do or say to anyone. I just ran to the toilet, shoved it on, and that was it, really. No time to think.
How proud are you of yourself for going out there and becoming seventh in the world?
I am really proud, because obviously I didn't actually warm up anything in the back gym. My competition, that was the first thing I've ever, like, out there was the first thing I did, like, warmed up. I didn't warm up. Oh, my God, I can't talk, sorry.
You didn't warm up at all, but you went out there. You're seventh in the world. Ondine, you're 13th in the world. This is your first all-around final. How did you find it?
It was just amazing just to be out there with everyone and all these, like, amazing gymnasts. And I just kept looking around, and everyone was so good. And I was like, ah!
Did you keep looking at one person in particular by any chance?
One person, yeah. Well, there was a lot of people, especially Simone Biles, but obviously just everyone. And I was trying to look, and then I had to go and do routines, and I was like, oh, dang it, I'm missing everyone.
What did you learn when you were out there that you can take going forward into next year?
Definitely staying calm. I think staying calm really does help, and as Alice did, she stayed very calm and it went very well for her. So,
Alice, I wonder if almost it was a blessing in disguise, because you couldn't overthink anything, you just had to get back out there.
No, definitely. I had no time to think, so I actually kind of thought it helped. I even said to my coach, maybe I don't need a warm-up anymore, but it's not going to happen.
I don't know what Christine Steele would think of that. Thank you both so much and congratulations.
Thank you.
Every session, please give me It's easy to forget, actually, that Ondine isn't even 20 yet. You know, she's been around for a while, but she, you know, came out of the juniors and she's really made her mark on the senior stage.
Yeah, she's done fantastic. I mean, we've seen her come through the ranks, There's always that nervousness. Can you step up from the junior ranks into the senior ranks? And you talk about her being the junior coming through, whereas now she's one of the more experienced members.
Absolutely.
Especially with Ruby joining the team.
Yeah, but of course, absolute respect to Alice Kinsella for stepping in there straight onto vault, and then to come seventh was absolutely incredible. But what a thing it was to witness Simone Biles back. And I mean, goodness, we said at the start, you know, a comeback's been so classy anyway. And I mean, she didn't disappoint. Right from the start. We'll just have a little look at some of her gymnastics. Let's look at that vault first of all, Beth.
Yeah, we know that she went for the easier vault for her.
Yeah.
Obviously still got a huge difficulty and great execution.
Yeah.
The bar routine was sublime. There was just very little to deduct. They worked very well with the code to work out what the best kind of routine construction is for her.
Because if there was a weaker piece for Simone, it would be this.
It is, yeah. Mm. But when you look at her scores, it's not actually that week.
No.
But you can see here, when we're talking about the twisties, she can double back that dismount, but she only uses the full twist. So I wonder whether that is one of the areas they've chosen to just keep with the single twist.
Yeah, and then, you know, when she's on beam, I mean, often you watch beam, don't you, and you sort of, you know, you're on the edge of your seat, but she just looks like she's working the floor.
Yeah, and also she's first up in this rotation because she's last up on the last piece. Mm. Sometimes that's easier, you get your routine done, whereas when you're further down the ranks on beam, you're sat waiting, it takes a long time to get up on the apparatus. So actually she got up, did her routine, and did it very well.
Mm. I mean, when you think, you know, she's been away, she's got married, she's sort of been living a kind of a different life, really.
Yeah.
But to come back for this quality and be able to just, you know, the difficulty levels, she's just seems to have just upped her game in an incredible way.
Yeah, and I think she's spoken about how she's obviously doing it for herself, she's enjoying it.
Mm.
And you can see that during the floor routine, after every tumble, there's the cheeky little smile and
yeah.
The choreography, the way they've constructed the routine. Again, they've gone for the single twists in the straight position. She does do one double twisting, but the height that she gets on all of her tumbles,
just like the extra time she seems to give herself, like on every piece, not just floor. But,
she has time to open out, to see the landings. I mean, there was a very uncharacteristic trip, and I think even listening to her after the competition talk about that was quite interesting. What do I do? As a gymnast, when you make those mistakes and you know you've missed out a skill, it's a case of, have I got enough skills still in my routine? Do I need to replace it with something?
Yeah.
But luckily, she had such an advantage going into the final rotation anyway.
Yeah, I mean, it raises the question, doesn't it, in the debate of, is she the finest sports person that's ever lived? I think so, because, you know, for me, gymnastics is the ultimate sport. It's the ultimate test of the body. And, well, she's the goat.
Yeah.
She's the human goat.
To go across such a length of time as well. I mean, we're talking 10 years since she won her first world title in the all-around, and 10 years later, she's just replicated that. And she's taken time out after the games, both after 2016 and after 2021, but still producing.
Yeah, yeah. And Rebecca Andrade, who took silver, she was celebrating to be all part of it, as well as Shailese Jones as well. And it was a magical women's all-round final, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we spoke about the ones that stayed on would be the ones that would be on the podium. And that's exactly what happened tonight.
Yeah, well, I think we've all thoroughly enjoyed it. We've welcomed back Simone Biles. She is just something else. Absolutely superb in every way, shape and form. But there you have it. Biles is back where she belongs, on top of the world. Thanks for your company tonight. We're going to be back with the apparatus specialists tomorrow, including Max Whitlock. And it's a chance for Biles to take even more gold home from Belgium. Good night.
Max Whitlock, 17, from South Essex.
That is a beautiful routine.
That was first class.
Well, I didn't think I'd get one, so to come over two, it's an amazing feeling.
Max Whitlock is the pommel horse world champion.
The man with the Midas touch. It's Max Whitlock.
It's a special age within British gymnastics, this. He becomes the most successful gymnast ever on this piece of apparatus.
I feel very lucky to be a gymnast. It's been an amazing journey.